Oh, sum up Miles in a few words.
Passion.
Passion.
Passionate. He's detailed.
Detail.
this is tough.
Opinionated.
He's rude. He smells.
Hairy.
Never seems to want to wear a suit.
Devoted.
Love.
Inspirational.
Fluffy.
Oh my love, let me be your fire. We're 1,000 miles up and I'm about to get higher. Feel my heart beating on my chest.
The atmosphere at football, particularly when you're 7, 8 years old and you're growing up, there's nothing like it.
It's probably his first love, his football. He's extremely knowledgeable.
I think I met Miles in about 1995. And it's somebody that my brother and I knew through the whole Champman thing.
Well, Miles was creating like a data update for Champman. I guess he didn't really like the data that the game was giving him, so he felt like he could make his own one and make it better.
In those days, we relied completely on this kind of Champman community.
He was then promoted to be like the official UK head researcher.
He was a player and he became a helper.
He was responsible for all the data research.
It became clear that the guy knew exactly where he was going.
And in the end, they relied on him as the kind of commercial guy for that studio.
My brother and I hadn't really made the best of the business side, and it made complete sense to get Miles on board to sort us out on that side, because Miles said to us, look, you two, great game, it's brilliant, but you're not gonna fulfill your potential. We need to get organized here. So he was perfect.
He came in, he took over all the shit bits that the Collier brothers didn't want to do. You know, he took the business side and let those guys focus on what they were really good at, which was making games.
He used to kind of run a business at the same time as being the head of Sports Interactive. And I remember when he said to me, right, this is it, I'm going to commit and I'm going to focus on Sports Interactive. And I thought, oh, this is it. Because the amount that he'd done already for the company when he was running two jobs, for to get all that energy focused in on the one job, I thought, this is it, we're really going to take off here.
But it was all still a little bit kind of bedroom amateur. Miles came in and he starts talking to these publishers like a businessman.
I first met Miles when we were publishing Championship Manager. The Collier brothers had appointed him as MD to look after their interests, and realised straight away that Miles was very forthright in his opinions. Some might say argumentative, but he certainly knew what he wanted, and he was a ferocious negotiator.
When Miles explains things, he does this with his hands. His little hands do this. And what it is his way of not pointing at you, but he's really pointing at you. And he does this. When there's one hand, he's making one sort of point. When there's two, he's bringing you in. Every company that's successful needs someone like Miles.
It was the first time that a brand was broken up, and we took the game code and the database, and Eidos were left with effectively just the name.
Miles put us in a position where it was stronger. We could grow the studio, we could reward ourselves, we could grow the game, make a bigger franchise, and essentially become a professional outfit, if you like.
Shine bright like a diamond.
I don't want to exaggerate here, but it is true to say that unless Miles had been around with us for 10 years, we would not be reaching 150,000 children this year.
Shine bright like a diamond.
There's every chance that we would be much smaller. Miles' money has been crucial. His support has been really important for us. But the doors that he unlocks and the ideas that he throws into us, and the fact that if something goes wrong, we're really worried that Miles is not going to be happy about it, that's what makes us and Miles a really good partnership.
He was one of the founders of GamesAid, and he's always been a massive supporter, and he still does the due diligence on all the charities.
He's not only working for them, he's not only trying to raise money and raise awareness, but he's also one of the biggest contributors himself. I mean, I would probably buy a car. He spends it into charity. And that's the person he is. I mean, probably he cares about people. And I think that's the reason why he got the prize.
Miles, I don't know how you do it, but you are having much more of an impact on the world than the average human being. And I really hope that whatever it is you do, you keep doing it for as long as possible.
You've been absolutely brilliant for this company.
We are so proud of you.
You're a true champion in what you do.
Absolutely love you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
You deserve it.